belief in Catholic faith, and while we don't preach every day, it is very much a part of the program. So please, Mr. Dogan, do you need the mic?
Yeah, please. Thank you.
How's everybody doing tonight? So in case you didn't hear that wonderful speech, my name is Joe Dogan, and I am your morality officer. Now this presentation, as you all can read, is the comparison between Catholic mysticism and the Shanahan rugby team. What is Catholic mysticism, you might ask? Well, this is a brief paragraph or two to describe just what it is. I'm not going to read it for you. Don't even recommend you reading it. But it is very interesting. It's very interesting. So, we, as a band of brothers, united through the balls of the three players, but more importantly, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, have overcome many challenges this year, and we, just the overall belief in our wonderful team captains, and especially officers, but more importantly, coaches and each other, we've been able to do great things this year. Things that some of us maybe didn't even think were possible, but we did okay. So, some might ask that, you know, rugby's kind of dangerous, like people get hurt, and Catholic mysticism is one of the most beautiful, transcendent consciousness that human body, or soul for that matter, could experience besides having. They are very much alike in a lot of ways. So, but I think one of the most important things that I learned about Catholic mysticism is that I see the just important figures of the history in our team, and I just would like to elaborate on that.
Careful,
so, Mr. Sherman is very tired. We decided to move that to but anyway, so St. Faustina was actually, I think she remembers Doyle, or Doyle resembles her, I should say. almost down to a T, as in they would give themselves and every ounce of themselves to the people that they cared about in situations when they needed to. Like, in the war, in her case, as she was living in the 1200s. And Doyle, with us, on the field, the pitch. Padre Pio, resembles a genuine spirit. I mean, I don't really want to brag too much about myself, but that was really the most scary thing that I could come up with. Hildengarda began. Brandon Harrison, he was a Norseman, he was a Viking, he was a lover of God. And I believe he was all of those. A great friend as well. A great friend. Didn't even matter to me though. He's there almost every time you need him. Sometimes, yeah. Hugh of St. Victor, Jamie Petrino, he was a beloved man. He fought courageously within the Crusades. Lost many a battle. Jamie Petrino did. He did. He had three tries, I guess. Maybe Unionville? I don't remember, but he has. Now, Richard of St. Victor, again, Pat Kelly. Hugh and Dick were buddies. They were buddies. But Richard, it was a... I don't want to say he was like a hermit, but... he was a hermit. And very much resembled you when I looked at his Wikipedia. And St. Francis of Assisi, I just... I can't really see anything about him. He's just a lover of animals. Very, very close with animals. So, through this year, we had a numerous amount of injuries, one of which displayed huge mood. This is when we were traveling by bus through the hills of France. The duo, I mean, they walked into a shirt, I mean a store, and they looked at these shirts and they go, my, we must have these. So they matched for a very wonderful dinner, a very short dinner, a very service-attentive dinner. I was joking, by the way. But it was very good. And that's just how we walked through the streets with these clowns in the back of us, just bringing up the rear because nobody wanted to stand next to us. Except for Pat. Pat was just in it. And then those are two of our team members and one of our team cheer leaders. But yes. Perseverance and determination. I think we were down a couple times this season, just a couple though. I think we powered back through most of them. And I think the reason, one of the most, I guess, magical, like, sports experiences that I've been a part of was the St. Joe's game. When, like, all week, you know, we were kind of, we didn't take them for what they were, we took them for what we thought they would be, which was not as good as they were. And that got the better of us in the first half, but then, like, we didn't stop once, and we just kept going. We pushed through, and we got the win, which I thought was one of the best feelings in the world. These pictures are from France. The first picture was before we played the game against the team in blue and white, and it was just a debacle. It was, yeah. We lost 50 to nothing.
It didn't count.
This was the game, and our French pals and Thor or Flappy or Eric Sanders, and they're breaking bread with the enemy. This was a coveted picture. It's actually framed and signed. Now these are some great memories. You know, the game scoring the try before he shattered his whole leg. And then again, this is another picture before France. I just thought that was one of the most memorable things. I think Coach Ford said to us that, you know, how lucky were we that we've been, I guess, picked to be. We earned it though. Everybody who was there worked for it. That we were in France playing rugby on a beautiful day on a beautiful field in a great stadium with a bunch of people around us watching us. And I don't think there's any better feeling. And I just think au revoir. Which is like French goodbye or something.